Morning! And welcome to Epcot Day number two. Gary had the idea that we harmonise, but you can't really harmonise on
nobody,
a G.
Nobody picked a note, so everyone just went for it.
I just spoke.
They had a lovely breakfast at Sinal this morning.
We did. I had the French toast, and I had the Eggs Benedict, which was lovely with hard poached eggs.
We had a nice chill morning. Gary C slept for a long time.
Yeah, forever and a day. He was
recovery talking, is needed.
He was talking to people, patrons and all that, and I was just asleep.
Now we go to the park. Hooray!
Woo! Hi.
Oh, have you ever seen that?
Yes, you have.
I have.
Thank you. The new magical music. I love it. It's so Epcot. It's so Epcot. Love the music. Love the music. Disney, put the music on Spotify. Please and thank you.
Turn it up.
Turn it up. Space Mountain was down. No, Space Mountain. Spaceship Earth. Hello. Morning. And now it is back up and running.
Each civilization has its own form of writing, which none of the others can understand. But the Phoenicians, who trade with all of them, have a solution. They created a simple common alphabet, adaptable to most languages. Remember how easy it was to learn your ABCs? Thank the Phoenicians. They invented them. It turns out there are copies of some of these books in the libraries of the Middle East, being watched over by Arab and Jewish scholars. Call it the first backup system. The books are saved, and with them our dreams of the future. In 1770, Gutenberg invents the movable type printing press. At first, very large, very expensive computers, but
welcome back, time traveler. Now, we invite you to visit Project Tomorrow.
How many Disney fans does it take to try and get a boarding group for Guardians of the Galaxy at 1 p.m?
Minimum of two. What do we do? 59.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now.
Thank you.
Well done, team. We've decided to walk around the world clockwise. Is that right? Yeah. Which isn't the normal way I'll do it, but you know, I'm just gonna grin and bear it. I know there's people out there that say this is the only way they go, but I'm a British boy and I go to Canada first. Which way do you normally go?
Whichever
Star?
Way the maple
I wasn't talking to you. Help. Star, which way do you normally go?
Whichever way the maple popcorn is.
We were planning on doing some festival food, but there's actually not as many stalls as there is for food and wine and flower and garden. So we've decided to on the quick service in the China Pavilion. I've never done it. You've never done
it. I've never done it.
You've never done it.
I've never done it.
Donald's never done it. So we're going to go over there now. So that's the Nine Dragons restaurant. Which I have been to, but the quick service is only outdoor seating, and when you're in the Florida sun, the last thing you want to do is eat outside sometimes. So now it's January, we can give it a go. So the quick service is just here on the left, and it's called the Lotus Blossom Cafe.
There's some pictures there, if you want to have a look. I think I might have the chicken fried rice, you know. Looks nice.
For us to get this, which was a vegetable stir fry and a chicken fried rice combo, drink each, that would have been $36.87, but on the dining plan it's two quick service credits, and we found a space right in back on the left hand side. What'd you get?
Orange chicken.
Ooh.
And a lychee iced tea,
as well as some chicken puff stickers,
and that came to $54.
What?
Yes,
no.
Yeah.
Is this alcoholic?
$52, no.
I'm shocked. How was your vegetable stir fry?
Really nice, loads of flavour.
just really, really nice. I would definitely recommend people who don't like spicy to get it and ask for like the white rice instead of the spicy noodles.
This is what you did.
Because the vegetable side of it is so flavorful and just nice. And then the white rice is just a nice little palate cleanser at the end.
Nice. I really like mine, however it is chicken thigh, brown meat, rather than chicken breast, white meat. So that's the only thing I wouldn't necessarily rate about this video, this meal. This video, really. We're still recovering from that Magic Kingdom day. How's your orange chicken, boys?
Really nice, very nice. This is white meat chicken, mm-hmm. So if you want white meat, get the orange
chicken.
It's not spicy at all. It's very similar to like our sweet and sour chicken Cantonese style.
So that's what you're paying.
And we also learned that they gave them the wrong drinks. So this is the drink they ordered.
Yeah, this is the lychee iced tea. Beautiful.
This is like a Chinese beer, right?
Yes. We're like hammered now.
There's some merchandise for the new show, including a die-cut magnet and a little Christmas ornament. Hi! Bonjour!
Thank you.
What did she say?
Enjoy your storybook adventures.
Oh, nice. What'd you get?
We consult the book. It is inspired by Encanto.
Oh, it looks
this
pretty.
Is the passion fruit filled mango cheesecake between France and Morocco.
That's nice. I like that.
Yeah.
Out of five?
I say five.
Yeah.
I say five.
A good five.
I say five.
Yeah.
As far as desserts go, I'm not really a sweet person, but.
Nice.
Gary has just made an observation.
Comes on cardboard now. Mm. However,
still loads of plastic cutlery.
But. I have noticed in the rooms, or our room at Wilderness Lodge, that I haven't lived in the public, they have cardboard plates and everything in there now.
Ah, Sleeping Beauty.
Oh! Yeah, I said to her, hello, princess. Here we have Luncheon of the Boating Party by Renoir. Please change positions. And one more. Thank you. Renoir would be very pleased.
And away we go! You ready, Star?
I'm ready!
Chef Patty is waiting for you. This way.
It's a bit fishy in here.
Very fishy.
Hey guys, the boat is for them, not you.
Good for someone with anxiety. Max and Alex don't currently have their umbrellas.
Someone forgot them. I said, shall we pack them? You were like, no, it's not forecast rain today.
How dare you? I said, let's pack them.
Anyway, we'll keep walking. We don't need a domestic in Epcot.
It doesn't matter if you're gay or straight. Domestics happen.
Oh, it's raining again.
Oh, it's raining again.
Wow.
Go on, do it.
I can't do it.
Go on, yeah you can. Get it in your gob.
This is a rainbow cookie.
Oh, it's dripping off the side. Just be careful with your blue.
Oh my God, the blue. Oh no, not the blue.
And it comes with a non-edible paintbrush.
Yeah, don't eat the paintbrush, Gary Z. Let the artist work.
What are you trying to do?
I was going to do our names, but...
That's too much work.
That sounds like a lot. The Artist Palette Jumbo Chocolate Chip Cookie near Canada. I would give that a 3. It wasn't nothing special for the money it was.
2. 1. 2.
Onwards we go. Yeah.
Do you want to see the little charging point?
Oh yeah, go on. Keep walking, we'll catch up.
In the new Epcot Pavilion, you lift up.
Ooh!
All the charging points.
That's clever!
Yeah. USB. Is that a USB-C? Or is that just
No, those
plug?
Are just plugs. So USB and plugs.
Yeah.
Nice! Where are we going?
DVC Lounge!
Yay!
I'm pretending to live through Adam as a DVC member.
Because you've never been up here yet?
Never. Oh, I've always wanted to.
And it looks like it's going to pour down with rain, so we chose the right time. Got new chairs!
I got a sticker.
Ooh!
I got a sticker.
Riviera! Oh, I didn't see it! Riviera sticker!
Cute. I'm going to put that on my bag.
In the table, they have USB, USB-C, and a plug.
Sad face.
Sad face. The great thing about coming up here, little snacks, and a refillable drink. And Gary gets to sit down.
But these are like the little graham crackers, the mini cookies I like.
Delicious.
Some people might say they're dry and boring, but that's my niche. So, I was number 4. I have reached my number 4 pot.
Yes, you are.
Where am I? I want to do something.
No. What is
you can't tell it's grey.
But it's free to do.
It's free to do. It's a fun little thing.
How many squares do you get out of it?
I got quite a few out of mine. Like 8.
Oh.
But also, there's about 5 minutes, well, 3 minutes now of this one left because they're timed. So everyone's like furiously trying to fill it in to finish it. And then I think they move on to another one.
Oh, right, okay. So
if you go down there, you can see like the whole thing. The music is very epic and like inspiring.
Yeah. Tonight we are having dinner at the Hacienda de San Angel or San Angel? I don't know how you say it. Angel? Angel! This is somewhere we've never eaten before. It's only open for dinner, but I'm very excited to try it out because I love Mexican food. And I've been to the Mexican restaurant in there, which I think is just called the San Angel restaurant. That wasn't a bit of me. So hopefully this one will be better. Mmm, smells nice. Ooh, smell nice. This is one of the restaurants that gives you a great view of the lagoon and potentially the fireworks as well. My advice for trying to get a table for that is to book something that's maybe an hour and a half before the fireworks and requesting a fireworks table. Try and turn up early for your reservation and say that you're happy to wait longer if they can get it for you. By 7:30, 8 p.m. if the fireworks are at 9, most of those tables are going to be assigned. So keep that in mind. The longer you give the restaurant to accommodate you, the better. With the dining plan, you obviously get an alcoholic or non-alcoholic speciality drink. This is basically the pina colada, but without the raspberry. So.
Obviously not the rum and everything, because I always have a virgin pina colada anyway. So it's basically tastes like the cruise ship one.
White sangria?
White sangria and chicken.
What?
Not for chicken. A drink.
Oh. Just a white sangria.
And then me and Max are going on soft drinks. And then we've also ordered queso, and we're all having some sort of chicken, I think.
I have a little surprise.
A surprise?
A little dairy.
Oh.
Who is it?
Oh no.
Who is it?
Oh no.
It's someone to join me.
Yay! Hooray! But he's got no magnets in there.
I'm gonna kill you.
Yes.
This is Little Mickey all over again.
What shoulder do you have yours on?
This side.
So I have mine on this side. When we have pictures together, it's like this.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome.
Chipotle salsa. Queso. Nachos.
Figment.
Oh god, here we go. This is it. This is the end.
Does he like it?
He likes it.
Thank you for not gifting this on day one.
I should have.
Do you think we should go around every park taking all the pictures again with you on my shoulder?
No, he says.
Yeah.
Words of the wise, the salsa
is very spicy.
Which is great, because it basically just means it's mine now. None of these three really like the spice.
She could have been more of like a chipotle sauce, didn't she?
Yeah, but I think chipotle is a type of pepper, isn't it? Type of chili.
Oh, chili.
Alex went for the chicken.
Ooh, that chicken.
Ooh, that mushrooms.
Demon. Max and I have gone for the fajitas. They so normally come with steak, but you can have it with chicken.
Yeah,
Then they also bring rice to share and corn and flour tortillas for the various meals. Churros and ice cream have arrived. So far, the reviews haven't been great from the other side of the table, so I'm going to...
Oh my god.
You're just going to have to pick it up and...
Okay.
I'm nearly there. Very hard, very chewy churros.
That cream's nice.
Yeah.
That cream's lovely.
Churros
actually,
not.
It's been a really lovely meal. And I think the churros just took it down a peg, because it was going to be a 4 out of 5 for me. This was pushing a 5. However, the churros have knocked it down a little bit for all of us, I think. I'm going to go... It would get a 3.5.
But we don't do halves.
But we don't do halves. I think because it was quite an expensive meal. Obviously, we're on the dining plan. Ho hum, ho hum. But if we weren't, I probably wouldn't have paid to come back here again based on that. So 3.
3. 4.
4.
My chicken was delicious and I didn't pay.
Yeah, the fajitas were really nice as well.
I'm going 3.
My chicken was delicious and I didn't pay. Chirp, chirp, said the goose. I give it 4 out of 5.
Interesting that the people who didn't pay paid.
This is really amazing, this part.
Beautiful. I could just spend an evening just listening to the music and sitting here and looking at the lights.
I wonder if the music's on YouTube or on Spotify.
I hope so. It's not on Spotify. I know that much. I've already had a little look. But they've done really... Like, I know that some people's feedback has been like they could have done more with the time that they had. But actually, I think this is very indicative of what the future might look like in that, you know, nature is incorporated with humans living and... entertaining community spaces and I like it.
Like, look, it's just an epic look.
Yeah, very nice. Soaring a tower, now taking off to California.
Soaring over California?
Yeah.
I haven't done this one in years.
What do you think, Gary?
Loved it.
Yeah?
I thought that the smells were so strong on this one.
What? I didn't even smell the orange.
Oh, they were strong.
Living with the land.
All aboard, who's going aboard?
Ugh. Welcome to the front.
Hi.
This is the closest thing you get to concierge on this cruise.
Oh.
Yes, your figment's very impressive. Thank you, Alex.
You're welcome. Very different at night, isn't it?
Yeah, very different.
These plants are definitely on their way up. Innovative growing techniques like these increase yields while more efficiently using resources like water, fertilizer, and pesticides.
Oh, this is good!
Yes! Yeah, Max, bringing out the dancing. So used to seeing a wall there, and now it's open. We are heading to get a spot for the new fireworks show, Luminous. We haven't seen this.
Luminous.
Gary, Max and Alex haven't seen this either.
Luminous.
We're very excited. This is the replacement for Harmonious, where it's not projectors or screens or anything. It is lights, fireworks, lasers, and fountains. So you can pretty much watch this from any good position around World Showcase Lagoon. In theory. To give you some perspective of where we're watching this, we are currently outside the Canada Pavilion. So if you know where the pieces of wood where the little maple leaves are, that's where we are.
My glasses are so clean I can see my eyes in them and it's freaking me out. Every now and then I'm like, what's that?
The Symphony of Lights. A dazzling display of fireworks, stunning special effects, and sweeping provincial music.
I'm sorry.
Thank you. they're cool.
Wow. Don't stop you crying, it'll be
in symphony.
harmonious. That was Luminous. See, that changes so much, I don't even know. Out of five, for a Disney nighttime spectacular, what are we going to say?
I'm going for a four. It's definitely to the point that it didn't make me cry, but I really enjoyed it.
Three, middle of the road.
I think a three is low for me.
Yeah, I'm going to go three as well. It was a nice fireworks show, don't get me wrong. But technologically, the fireworks are very impressive.
Mm-hmm.
There was a couple of lulls which didn't really fit for me. And, I don't know. Yeah. It just didn't hit right.
Yeah.
Also, the songs were sung by random singers. If it was the actual singers and the actual songs we know in an arrangement, then maybe it would have been more...
Like Wondrous Journeys.
Yeah, Wondrous Journeys.
Wondrous Journeys, where they put the millennial sort of classics into an arrangement that was really impressive.
Like, the last few times, haven't they? Like, Enchantment, they were random covers, weren't they?
Yeah, even Happily Ever After has been.
Yeah. Good thing I would say is it really doesn't matter where around World Showcase you stand, you will get the same view whatsoever.
It's worth being able to see the fountains, but they don't go very high,
so you don't have to get amazing view.
I like the start.
The start was nice.
Yeah, the finale was really good. Yeah. I like the finale.
Your theme song is great, the first song. I was thinking from the theme song, this is going to be five stars.
Yeah.
And then with the lost section, it was just like...
And it wasn't an emotional...
No. Yeah.
It was like a...
We're very distant here.
Yeah. So, I don't know. I've definitely seen better. And I'm not sure if this would be enough to keep me in the park until the end of the day.
Bring back Harmonious.
I love Harmonious.
Well, I don't think they're going to bring it back anytime soon, so...
Illuminations! Bring back Illuminations!
But if it's your first time here, definitely worth watching.
Oh, yeah, I would agree. It's a
nice fireworks show.
We just had the funniest experience ever. So literally, the second... I'm crying, I want to laugh so much. The second we finished giving you the review, this Disney cast member came around who was clearly like a manager or something like that, and he had a notepad and he was like, sorry, the camera battery died. Once we finished filming the clip that was like reviewing Luminous, a cast member came up to us and was like, hi guys, did you watch the show? And we were like, yeah. And he was like, do you have any feedback? And he had a notepad with us.
Clearly from like customer service, wasn't he?
Or like review. Research or something. Yeah. And yeah, we've got feedback if you want it. And he was like, yeah, give it to me. And so we kind of told him everything we told you, and that we want, well, you put it really well.
Because I'm amazing.
Like nostalgia.
When you cry at Disney, you don't want to be thinking of sad times. You want to think of joy, nostalgia, hope.
And like, I can do anything.
Yeah.
And that's why things like Go the Distance, A Whole New World, are such classics.
And he was saying, like, do you think the Disney songs fit in this park? And we were like, we don't need Disney songs in this show because it's all about the world, and that's fine. So, yeah, we told Disney exactly what we thought. And he was flipping the pages and like, and we were like, oh, we're trying to slow down. He was like, no, this is great.
He's worried about this.
So he's got to type it all up.
Yeah.
Now, since we've had quite a long day, I have decided to treat us to a minivan. So I've just ordered this on the Lyft app, and we're going to be going to the beach club to pick it up because it's a little bit closer to where we were other than the front.
Oh, it's lovely here.
Yeah, it is lovely.
I do love this area. It's one of my favourite areas on Disney Club.
Gary, what was your highlight? Do you have one?
Meeting Figment.
Oh, of course.
And getting my little baby Figment from Alex and Max.
I was about to say, mine was going to be the excitement on Gary's face when he saw baby Figment.
And the eye roll on mine. When ordering a minivan, you can order it from anywhere on Disney property to anywhere else on Disney property, which comes in mighty handy when you want to get out of the parks quickly.
Apart from Magic Kingdom. It doesn't stop there, does it?
Yeah.
Does it?
At the bus terminal.
Yeah,
it's one of the only places that you can actually get out of Magic Kingdom quite quickly.
I didn't write a book on Disney. Don't listen to me.
But I did. Head to adamhattan.com now. The book is currently 50% off. Terms and conditions apply. Offers may end.
The trick with minivans is they tend to take a while because there's not many cars. So when you're kind of starting to walk out the park, that's when you want to order one. We ordered it when we were in Canada, after we just finished speaking to that cast member. And it took about 18 minutes from ordering it until then. So we've just got to Beach Club, we still got 5 minutes to wait.
Enjoying your holiday over there. You ready for bed?
I've been ready for bed for days.
This is us.
I'm not gonna lie, it never gets old.
Thank you very, very much.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Did you enjoy the minivan ride?
They're always very good drivers, and they're always nice to talk to.
That was a lovely ride.
It's more expensive than an Uber. That was $40 to go from back of Epcot to here. It was quite a long drive, really.
Yeah, and it was worth it for the comfort because it also started raining.
I never looked back. I enjoyed the step.
Please do your impression of the fireworks show. My personal favourite one is... Well, I'd call that a day.
A very successful day.
Yeah, yeah. We got to see the new show. That's what our main thing on the bucket list was. And it was nice to see World Celebration. I think that's probably the highlight of my day.
And the Mexican was nice.
Yeah.
Really nice.
Yeah. Churros lit down the end. But it was still nice to do it and try it. And I think if you... got in there at the right time, it would be a really great place to see the fireworks and stuff like that. Yeah. But yeah, well, we're going to leave you here. I'll see you for the last vlog in this series. But don't fear, I've always got more magic coming. So don't forget to subscribe. I thought you had something to say.
I was getting ready for the end.
I thought there was something in your bag. Oh, no, just your good night pills.
Just the good pills.
Like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the future stuff. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.